Here's our video of our recent field trip to Mungo National Park. We start off with a group photograph. 19 people in all. 2,650 kilometres to travel. Here's Warwick, our leader. We start at the Yanga National Park. This is the homestead. And the farm buildings and fences around the homestead. Warwick Wright found a snake skin. The wetlands looks really good at the moment. They have had rain. This bird is a spoonbill. Historic fencing from the farming days. We're now in Mungo National Park. Lots of timber went into those fences. Here's some of the erosion in the walls of China, which are part of the Mungo National Park. A group photograph of some familiar faces there, doing a bit of botanizing, I suppose. Salt bush.
Absolutely. But even here, see that little sign there, could have easily had.
More botanizing. The field guide's got a good working over, as you can see. Ben Wallace with his camera. Zhao Mei. nice blue flower. Here's the group again.
The others were arguing over that.
Going up onto the dunes. Mungo. On the dunes again, taking a rest.
Just hear a college
more of the dunes looking down.
A while in the back. It's in Victoria. Victoria.
Not the one that Shirley was saying.
That doesn't look like
Victoria. What are the fruit like?
Well, I'm just checking to see if it's the same.
Get Ben to photograph it.
A bit of discussion, right, discussion about what's that?
Small and dark.
So it's not a petrosal.
It's not, no.
Yep. Our friend was a Sue, is it? She said it was a good one. I think it's not. It's not Pitocerum.
Richard's wife. We're all puzzled about what her name is. It'd be nice to know. Do you happen to know?
Hello, Richard's wife.
Sorry? I've got a little bit. Same. Yeah. Any glands?
It's slightly sticky. Yep. Slightly shiny.
Any glands? That's the test for wobbles.
Field guides out again. That's the walls of China behind, distance shot, so it's a bit blurry. Built up over thousands of years and now eroding. Another shot there on the dunes.
Quite sweet.
Yeah.
But because I remembered that the bird eats it and then it goes.
Another shot of the walls of China. the ruins of the Zonzi property. Walls of China in the background behind the wooden fences. The ruins of the Zonzi wool shed. Down in the cellar in Zonzi. Lovely timber work. Ruins of the old water tank. Tank stand, old and new. We're now at Wentworth, at the confluence of the Darling River and the Murray River. Nice water views here. Here's the group up on the lookout. a red-rumped parrot. Very comfortable with all of the tourists watching it. And the pale-headed Rosella.
Never a dull moment.
It's a lovely place. Thank
not
you.
Bad children.
Yeah,
really.
Thank you very much, Shirley and Warwick.
Yeah, I hope I don't sound.
Well, all welcome. I can say is thanks for surviving me for this long.
For the second time?
Yeah, well,
wonderful to get a group shot here. Yeah, that's a good idea.
Royal National Park.
Personalised tour. Which way is the Murray from? Which
way? You can tell because it's because the water's DO2 rather than H2O.
Yeah, H2O if you're riding DO2.
Excuse me, can I just get past and get out of people's way? Oh, sorry.
I don't
it's a fantastic picture. Oh, yeah.
I think they're idiots, aren't they? Oh, look at that. He's actually building a lift.
He's caught the Apollos. This tells you.
Yeah. Look. He's actually bringing it. Look. Hey, you dropped it, you silly child.
That was Mike teaching the galah how to make a nest. We've moved on now to the Boronga Botanic Gardens. This is the shed, which is their meeting room, built of timber. Nice shot of an Australasian darter posing for the camera. We're just out of Narandra now. And now to the wetlands, a bit further out of Narandra. And there were a lot of swans there. Nice water shot. We've moved on now to the road to Galore Hill. Quite a few plants here, especially a few in flower. quite a few Eremophilas here. Eucalyptus in flower. Giant pods. Up on top of Galore Hill, lunch, a great field trip. Thanks very much, Warwick.